Hello everyone, so today we're gonna make some sablé viennois. This one is fantastic. It's very short, very light, very buttery, vanilla-y. Everything's nice about this biscuit, so let's make it. It's very easy. So we're just gonna start by melting some chocolate. We're gonna temper some milk chocolate for the finished touch. So once the biscuit is cooked, we're gonna dip it in the chocolate halfway. So we're using Valrhona chocolate, obviously. So good chocolate. Just enough for what we need. So it's melting on the bain-marie, yeah? Then, for the biscuits, we need 570 of butter. Little bit, yeah. Soften in the microwave, which is gonna be mixed, so we can do it by hand, but as everybody knows, I'm so lazy that I'm doing in the mixer. Icing sugar. Oh no, it's finished. I got some more. 225 of icing sugar. Oh, I can't believe he's missing 20 grams. I got a bag. I'm coming. Where is he? There. Here I am. Okay. Just for 20 grams. So we said 225, yeah? Yeah. So that be mixed with the butter, soften, which should be ready now. Little bit more. Up. Then we need some salt. We need 14 grams of salt. In there. Up. We're gonna need some egg white. 180 grams of egg white. That's from some eggs I clarified before. I keep the egg white. Yeah, 180. The butter is soft with the icing sugar. Just gonna give a stir by hand, because if we put it straight in the machine, it's gonna fly everywhere. See? I'm the machine. Like that. Okay. So up. It's roughly mixed. Let's finish it with the paddle. Okay. Until it goes nice and fluffy and white. Need to check our chocolate. So the chocolate, we're melting it at 45 degrees, yeah, to temper it. So once it's melted at 45 degrees, we let it cool down to 26, 25 degrees. and bring it up to 30 degrees, 29-30 degrees for the milk. So the chocolate now is at 45 degrees. Huh? I don't need a thermometer because I'm used to it, but you can use thermometer. So now you can just leave it on the side and we're gonna let it cool down. This one is nice and creamy and it became slightly white. So we're gonna add the egg white slowly. There. I've been waited up some flour as well. So the flour, it's 675 grams, which we're gonna sieve. So 675. There. So now we're gonna just flavor our butter mixy with some vanilla. So I got a very good vanilla essence. Oh, you can scrape a vanilla pod on it, in it. Or you could put some pistachio paste. I like vanilla. There we go. And now we're just gonna fold the flour. So sometimes, if your egg white were too cold, it kind of split your mix. So you got to, if it's splitting, you got to warm up slightly with a blue torch all around, bring it up to life. I'm not sure if it's over too. If it's just slightly split, it's okay, you can just put the flour. But it's better to take your egg white out before to make it. Everything is at room temperature. You won't have any problem. Okay, so this one up, the flour. I'm just gonna fold the flour. I will finish it in a machine. Make sure you catch the bottom of your bowl. There we go. Not too much mix. Soon the flour is incorporated, you can stop. Make sure everything is well combined together. And that's it. Okay, so on a black tray, parchment paper, little bit of mixture to stick the paper. There. And that, we're gonna pipe it. Oh, you can do a lot of different shape. But the classic one is gonna be this one. That'd be the classic. So that's the classic. And in the oven, it's gonna melt, but keep the shape. Then because it's Christmas, we could do a Christmas tree. So how are we gonna do that? Like that, maybe? Voilà, that's a Christmas tree. Let's get some little bubbles. There are some little ones. Anything you're ready, anything you fancy to do. I'm gonna pipe another one, and that's it. There we go. Okay, so that's a nice color, golden. So they are ready. Up. Big one might need a little bit more. So what we're gonna do, up. Put the big ones back. This one's already. Yeah, another 5 minutes. Up. So now that's it, they're all cooked. We're just gonna let them cool down. And then we'll be able to dip them in the chocolate. So the chocolate, we keep an eye on it. You know, it's cooling down nicely. And when it's gonna thicken very much, it'll be at 25 degrees. And then at this stage, we can warm it up, bring it up to temperature 29, 30. And then it'll be tempered. So our sablé are cooled down now, or cold. And the chocolate has thickened. So you see, now it's at 25 degrees. It's even setting on the sides. So now it's time to bring it up to 29, 30 degrees for the milk. So I'm using a hot air gun to temper the chocolate. We have to be careful not to overheat it, otherwise we have to start the process all over again. So bitter little bit by little bit. Without thermometer, I can tell by the consistency. has looked all right. We're gonna do a little testy testy on a piece of plastic. Just cover it aside and we're gonna stick it in the fridge like that. See if it's gonna set as we want. Okay, so I'm pretty sure it was fine, but just in case, so it set, it cracks, and it's shiny, so that means it's ready, right? So we can carry on dipping the little biscuits. Up. And those biscuits will keep quite a while in a nice closed box. So if we do the big ones, yeah, sablé viennois. It's really nice, very light, very short. What about the tree? Side, voilà. Up. And maybe we can do little decoration on top. Make it a bit more Christmassy. Piece of fudge, piece of raisins, piece of nuts. Why not? I've never done that. It's like a fat tree, you know. Okay, let's carry on with our little mini. And that's it. That's all easy. Okay, and if you like to join us on our Facebook page, up there, or down there, is the subscriber on our channel. Thank you very much. Bye bye.